The history of Lifeline has originated here in Sumner, Iowa. Been here for almost 40 years. It was started with father-son. They wanted to build an ambulance that they felt proud to sell.
You know, the product we make saves lives. I think the key differentiator is two things. The robustness of the vehicle we make is bar none the best. It's solid, it's robust, it's gonna keep people safe. The technology of it is up to snuff and meets the requirements. That's the main thing. And right along with that is we will customize it to just about whatever a customer wants. It became much more difficult to attract labor, to get labor, because unemployment rates were so low.
So it's harder to bring people in, a little harder to keep people. Over the last 25 years, sanding has probably been one of the more physically demanding jobs that you have to do. It's up and down ladders, dragging hoses, just hauling your equipment around. When you're sanding a truck, you can't stop. You pretty much just have to go. I'm sure you can imagine how it feels to crawl around on a metal roof all day. You definitely feel it in your knees, your legs, up and down the ladders all day. It adds up by the end of the day.
We're not eliminating jobs because of it. It's more filling the gaps where it's hard to get people to do the work.
That's one of them jobs that nobody wants to do, and the robot does it for us.
The future to me is to continue the automation roadmap of how do we make things, the tedious jobs, more efficient. But I think automation plays a big key in that.
If we're behind in this area, or say we didn't get some parts, we need to catch up on this or this, we actually have the manpower to send around to do it now.
We had been looking at a custom build company to do an engineer to order robot that would sand. There was some things that were kind of close, but not really anything close.
They were companies that were selling you a robot, and then you had to basically figure everything out.
There's companies out there that'll promise the world, that'll have great salespeople, but once you get the actual product from them, they just kind of disappear. And GrayMatter for us has been, you know, very responsive, very easy to work with. We're not left on an island, we're not ignored. So that's probably the biggest positive I can say about it. And the quality of the product is there also.
To see that in action and then to have the opportunity to send our product and material to the facility and then go watch it take place in real life was like, where have you guys been?
When they came in and set it up, I mean, they had one crew that came in and it was set up really fast. Then they had the software team come in and they worked with us really well in getting everything set up. And then even after they left, when we have a problem, we send them a text, they call us back or send a text back. Every time that we've had a problem where somebody needs to be, they're usually here the next day or like a couple of days, they fly right in and help us figure stuff out with the person right on site.
And the part that impressed me from the get-go is GrayMatter was very open about, you know, it's not gonna be perfect right out of the gate. You know, there's gonna be incremental improvements, and from a programming standpoint, we're gonna learn a lot of things that will help us out.
There was a large concern about making the capital expense into a piece of equipment that you could not demo, you could not see.
You didn't have to lay out, you know, $1 million+ right out of the gate without really knowing if the product's gonna work the way you really think it should. GrayMatter isn't going to be successful unless their customers are successful because of this model. We've seen some pretty good gains the last 2 or 3 months in particular. We've seen probably 30-40% reduction in time it takes in that area.
When we first started, we were thinking like 3.5 hours to almost 4 hours to sand a raw truck, and now we're seeing those raw trucks more into like the 3 hour time period. So that's, you know, like, and from the start till now, we've cut like 45 minutes off of it. And then as far as timing for the primer truck, we were at like 2.5 to 3, and now 80 to 90% of the trucks were right at 2 hours for each truck through the sanding cell.
GrayMatter's been great to continue to work with and continue to improve the automation and improve the software behind it to get where we need to go.